warmer.
Yeah.
Here, than it is almost everywhere.
Yeah, pretty much. You know, we are stuck in this bitterly cold air almost across the entire country, pretty much just east of the Rockies. So we actually have wind chill advisories or wind chill warnings anywhere that you see this light blue or sort of that periwinkle lavender sort of color out there. It is really cold everywhere, extending all the way down, even to the bayou area. So we are not alone, for one thing. And do keep in mind that if you are going to be traveling somewhere, you may be stepping off a plane in very harsh wind chill, just like we've got here. So you're going to have to go at least somewhere other than the majority of the eastern two-thirds of the U.S. to get away from that if you're trying to beat it. However, things are at least quiet on the larger scale when it comes to our overall weather pattern, and it doesn't necessarily stay that way. We've got a very large storm system that's going to be developing and bombing out, as we call it, over the open ocean water. But this is one model's interpretation of how things will take place. So this is Wednesday night into Thursday that we stand our best chance to see any snow. But notice, into a good portion of Thursday, this is already moving far off to our north and east. So especially Wednesday night into very early Thursday, we've got the possibility that we see some snow. Your better chance is going to be the closer you get toward that coastline. The models definitely differ on the exact track, but there's consistency that the bulk of this is going to bypass us. So we still need to keep a close eye on how this will eventually have any impact, if any at all, on our area. But Wednesday night to Thursday would be the time frame, and then it's just windy and frigid again as we wrap up the week. So the colder getting reinforced all over again, and the temperature changes right before your very eyes here on these live observations outside Pleasant Valley Middle and High School. Still a blanket of snow on the ground underneath the light of the street lamp there, but up at Broadheadsville and pretty much everywhere else, you're just stuck in that harsh chill. So here's a specific forecast for the Mummers this morning. Remember, between those skyscrapers, it can feel even worse with the wind picking up. Sub-zero wind chills are just forecasted as it is. It might be as bad as 7 below 0 at step-off time at 9 a.m. 11 degrees, though, technically, is what we're expecting on the thermometer. So please be smart about how you prepare to be out in this kind of cold, even for a couple of minutes. It really is quite harsh. Now, we rebound and almost crack 32 degrees come Wednesday. I don't think we're going to quite get there. It's going to be a close call. Meanwhile, again, tail end of the week, that harsh cold is getting reinforced all over again. So, Rahel, we're stuck in the teens again, and the coldest day is still yet to come.